Have you ever seen those creepy viral videos with human faces transforming into other people or animals and asked to yourself, how is this done? Then, here is the video you waited for. Let's dive into the subject. GANs, or Generative Adversarial Networks, is a recent class of machine learning frameworks that was first introduced by Ian Goodfellow and his colleagues in 2014. It is a powerful approach to generative modeling using deep learning methods, such as convolutional neural networks. Generative modeling is an unsupervised learning task in machine learning that involves automatically discovering and learning the regularities or patterns in input data in such a way that the model can be used to generate or output new examples that plausibly could have been drawn from the original dataset. GANs are a clever way of training a generative model by framing the problem as a supervised learning problem with two submodels, the generator model that we train to generate new examples, and the discriminator model that tries to classify examples as either real, from the domain, or fake, generated. The two models are trained together in a zero-sum game, adversarial, until the discriminator model is fooled about half the time, meaning the generator model is generating plausible examples. In this case, zero-sum means that when the discriminator successfully identifies real and fake samples, it is rewarded or no change is needed to the model parameters, whereas the generator is penalized with large updates to model parameters. Alternately, when the generator fools the discriminator, it is rewarded, or no change is needed to the model parameters, but the discriminator is penalized and its model parameters are updated. We can think of the generator as being like a counterfeiter, trying to make fake money, and the discriminator as being like police, trying to allow legitimate money and catch counterfeit money. To succeed in this game, the counterfeiter must learn to make money that is indistinguishable from genuine money, and the generator network must learn to create samples that are drawn from the same distribution as the training data. Because the GAN framework can naturally be analyzed with the tools of game theory, we call GANs adversarial. But what are their usage? Well, they are used in a lot of different applications. One is their ability to generate high-resolution versions of input images, create new and artistic images, sketches, painting, and more. It has the ability to translate photographs across domains, such as day to night, summer to winter, and more. GANs have been able to generate photos so realistic that humans are unable to tell that they are of objects, scenes, and people that do not exist in real life. There are many research reasons why GANs are interesting, important, and require further study. GANs open a lot of exciting opportunities since it's generating data when you don't have access to a lot and requires no human supervision, which is ideal for deep learning applications. Please leave a like if you learned something and subscribe to the channel to not miss any terms clearly explained.